Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, we're going to take a look at the voiceover feature within LumaFusion, and I'm going to show you how to get the best out of it, basically. So, tap on voiceover, and if you're using a keyboard on your iPad, you can press the V key to get into the voiceover feature. You've got three icons on the left-hand side. X is obviously to close the voiceover feature. The white circle is your record button, and then the three little white circles are basically your options. Now, the one thing I would recommend is the audio input gain, regardless of what microphone you're using, crank it right up to around about 95%, just to improve the overall audio gain. Sample rate, I would keep it at the highest setting, 48 kilohertz, and then obviously record in stereo. Can't think of a reason why you want to record in mono, but if you do, you can switch it here, but at the moment, I would keep it to stereo. But be aware, if you do change the channels, the audio input gain will automatically change again and reset, so just increase it back up. Come back out of the options and you're pretty much ready to record. So if you press on the little record circle, what happens is it gives you a 3 second countdown. So if you've previously recorded audio, it will actually back up 3 seconds worth and you'll hear yourself speaking and then, or background audio or whatever, and then you will start the actual recording. So if you've got headphones on, don't get sort of caught out by that and think, oh, it's playing this while I'm recording and the two are going to be clashing with each other. It doesn't work like that. So we basically press on record, there's your countdown, you get a little audio beep, and then it basically starts recording and you can see it working its way through. And that's kind of it. All you've got to do is just say what you need to say, like I'm doing right now, and once you're finished, just press on the blue circle and you'll then get a review option. So you can play back your audio, which we can do just now, and then it basically starts recording and you can see it working its way through. And if you're happy with that, click the little green tick box and that then lays down your audio track that you can see here. Now, what we'll do here is we'll zoom into it a little bit and we'll take a closer look at the waveforms and actually improving this vocal somewhat. Okay, so we've got our audio track. Now what I've done is I've made a duplicate of it below and just colored it red, and that's what that audio track is. Now what I'm going to do just now with this red audio track is basically disable it and switch it off, so you're just going to hear the original audio track above. And if you've never used the little locks and visibility and audio settings and linking and things like that on the left hand side, this is from these little buttons here, you can see. So if you tap on them, it opens this out. So if you want a cleaner timeline, you can remove them. I like them to be open all the time, so just thought I'd point that out to you. Okay, so let's play back the audio recorded. And then it basically starts recording and you can see it working its way through. And that's kind of it. All you've got to do is just say what you need to say, like I'm doing right now. And once you're finished, just press on the blue circle. And I ended the audio at that point. So that's the basic audio. Now what I'm going to show you in the red channel, which we will now switch on, and I will switch off the green audio, is we'll go into our audio settings. And what we're going to look for is one of the little features you've got in terms of creating EQs and things like that for your audio. And we're going to choose Dynamics Processor. And I use this a lot. So tap on it and then you'll see there's further options for presets. If you tap on them, you've got a choice of fast and smooth, hard, light gate, medium gate, and hard gate. Now from my understanding, a gate is when this audio, the sound gets compressed when you're not speaking. So in other words, the points of silence and things like that, it basically really dampens them back down. If you've got any sort of external like background noise or anything like that, it helps to smooth all that out. So I tend to use a medium gate. The other thing that I do is go down to the bottom and increase the master gain and lift it up roughly 5 decibels. It doesn't have to be overly accurate. And then if we come back out, I will play the original audio again for a second or two so you hear it, and then it basically starts recording and you can see it working its way through. And I'll then disable it and go back and play you the new audio with the Dynamics Processor in place, and then it basically starts recording and you can see it working its way through. Not too much of a difference, but the audio is a bit clearer and it's a bit louder, and obviously you can increase the decibels and just expand it a little bit more if you want to in the master gain. The next thing I'm going to show you is editing the audio. So at this point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to unlink the audio here so that it's separated from the original audio, and I'll just delete the original audio recording and move up my audio that has been processed. And you can also tell it's been processed by the little audio icon at the beginning of the waveforms there. So when it comes to editing audio, if we zoom in a little bit, what I tend to do is edit out any kind of dead space, or also tend to edit breaths out as well. So if I play it through, and then it basically starts recording, and you can see it working its way through. I don't know if you heard that there, but at this point here, just between here and here, I took a breath. Now, it's more subtle once you've applied the dynamics processor, but it is there. So what I would tend to do is I would tend to highlight the audio track, go to the beginning of it, and just basically trim off any dead space, move the audio, and then just go through the track and click start recording, and you can see it. So we've basically got a wee bit of dead space here. So I can go to here, Command B, and just trim out that. Take out that little clip, move everything up. And then we've got a breath here. So I just start at the beginning of the breath, trim out the majority of it. You don't want to take it right up to the edge of the waveform. You need to leave a little bit of room. And you'll now see when I play this through, and then it basically starts recording, and you can see it working its way through. And that's kind of it. And you'll notice there's a lot of dead space here. Sometimes you need that dead space. For example, when I'm playing back a clip that I'm teaching you guys about, I might want to just stay quiet. And obviously with the medium gate in place, it kind of just makes it completely silent. But sometimes you want to sort of reduce this amount of dead space. So again, just trim it up. And you can either do a cut and then slide up and just move everything along, or you can just do another trim to the other side, whatever way you want to work its way through. And that's kind of it. All you've got to do is just say what you need to say, like I'm doing right now, and there's another breath just there. So when you start to recognize your own vocal and the waveform of your breaths being taken, you can basically go through your edits, highlight your audio, and just trim out those breaths. And it just makes for a much cleaner audio. The other thing you can also do is, if you just want that to be dead space, is leave the audio as it is, play it through doing right now, and once you're finished, just press on the blue circle, and you could literally work it that way if you don't want to actually compress the audio track and bring everything right the way up. So if we just play it through one more time, and then it basically starts recording, and you can see it working its way through. And that's kind of it. All you've got to do is just say what you need to say, like I'm doing right now, and once you're finished, just press on the blue circle. And again, there's another piece here where it's a little bit too quiet, so I would trim that up, and maybe not trim the actual video, which helps. So I'll highlight the clip again, just trim there, delete the clip, and then move everything up. And I'll not play the whole thing, but I'll take it back a bit. Say what you need to say, like I'm doing right now. And once you're finished, just press on the blue circle. And there you have your full audio clip. So if we just reduce the overall timeline, you can see the cuts that I've made to the audio and how it plays into the actual timeline. And this is basically what I do for my video tutorials. And if I'm doing a voiceover for a documentary or a little piece to camera that I'm, you know, doing in terms of B-roll and talking over it, I go through this process every single time. And it just makes the audio so much cleaner by, when you're recording the voiceover, you increase the input gain and then use a dynamics processor, which I think is one of the best sort of EQ setups within LumaFusion. Choose a light or a medium gain, gate, and then from there, you then cut out any dead space or breaths that you've made within the audio, and then just play it back. And then it basically starts recording, and you can see it working its way through. And that's kind of it. All you've got to do is just say what you need to say, like I'm doing right now. And once you're finished, just press on the blue circle, and there we go. We're done for today. So that's what I do when I'm doing a voiceover, and I also use the exact same process when I'm recording the screen that I do for you just now. I will go through, take out any bits of dead space that I don't want, although sometimes you do need it, and also remove any breaths. So hope you've enjoyed the video tutorial. Give the video a like, and if I've earned your subscription, click on the little join icon and subscribe to the channel, and I will catch you on the next video. Bye.